the mixer on your computer.
Yeah, I use this voice meter banana that I've mentioned before as a soft mixer.
Yeah.
I'll share my screen again. And so what that lets me do though, is I can adjust individual. So this is my guitar coming in and hardware one. This is the mic coming in hardware two. And then I'm not using hardware three right now. It also lets me add a little color to my voice. So like I have a little bit of echo or reverb on my voice. And then it lets you record whatever tracks you pick. And this way you're actually hearing, when I have the computer play, you're actually hearing that through the voice meter aux, and then that mixes it in with my playing. And so like when we hear the drum set, that's the drum set coming in. So it's probably a little loud, but.
No, it's good, it's a good level. All your levels are good, great tonight.
So then what I'm trying to do is, say that puts the guitar right there at kind of the middle of B1, which I think is about, that puts the guitar at about minus 17 decibels, which I think is where we're trying to get. Minus 18 is what I've heard people say over and over again. Try and get everything to minus 18.
Okay.
Yeah. Exactly.
I didn't know.
I think that's, if you're feeding it to a professional mix board, that's what the professional mix board wants.
Okay, that makes
sense.
Is
what they're thinking is, if you can get your sound out to minus 18, then the board takes it from there and amplifies it for the house.
I was like, in Second Life, I don't even, I can barely get them to turn up, so.
I still need to study that. I finally found, now I did sign up for the Second Life to become a member thing. Mm-hmm. So I wanted to mention in passing, so I have a house in Second Life if you need somewhere to go and do things.
It is a good idea to have your own space. So it's a little chunk of change for me that I don't have yet. At the moment, I have some place that's letting me do that. I've created a second avatar to be my, not my manager, just a support person. So I've been fixing him up, and you saw him yesterday.
Yes.
I've changed his name to Charles.
Good.
But Charles eventually will be Soundbite Production in there. And then
good.
We'll have Soundbite Production promotions and stuff in there.
Yay.
But yes, thank you. That's great. You'll have to send me a link
Yeah, I'll have to study how to do that because reasons. And I still haven't figured out how to change the music there on that parcel of land to, I think you had pointed me at the sound place where you set, and I set up a station there. I haven't worked.
Tracks.
I haven't got it straight in my mind about how you connect the output of the computer to the station there. I did find the place finally where how to tell your parcel of land use that station for its sound.
Yes.
So I've got that part down. So next what I want to study is how do I broadcast from the computer to that repeater. I'm not using the right word, but that radio station.
You need to download BUTT. B-U-T-T, it's the streamer. You need a streamer in order to
and
broadcast.
Then you tell it that station.
Yes.
That
and
you
tell
signed
it that
up
address
for. And then tell the parcel that station.
Yes.
And that should bounce it from the computer.
And you gotta buy a stream from Tracks because it's the most efficient and the oldest streamer in Second Life. It's like $7.50 a month or something. Totally worth it though. I just pay 3 or 4 months at a time to it.
That's what I like on stuff like that is get it as a birthday present or something and pay the whole year and mark it done so that you don't have to worry about, oh no, should I spend $7.50 on that or should I just throw it in the street?
Yes is the answer.
This song that we're trying this week for the first time is Closing Time by Semisonic, which strikes me as quite singable. And that one.
It's a bar song.
It's a bar song. He also wrote this when his when they were expecting their first child. And so actually some of the lyrics have to do with the child leaving the womb and coming into the world. My wife was like, that's gross.
That's gross.
And she's all about the childbirth, but not when she's thinking about bars. So.
Right. Nasty.
But it's that metaphor, I think, of leaving the bar at the end of the night is like being born out into the world.
Kind of, yeah, I get that. That makes
One of my
sense.
Friends used to say he could drink all night and it didn't bother him at all, but as soon as he stepped outside the bar, the oxygen would hit him and he'd feel drunk. And so
true
it was
that.
The oxygen you got to watch for.
It is a true statement. I see that.
So this is going to be Closing Time by the Canadian group Semisonic. My name is Bruce Nunnally.
Lyrics were on point, strumming was on point, vocals were on point. However, some reason the system went, it did that warbly thing again. It took you
Ooh.
into the.
Do we have something? Do we have that sound turned on? Is the question. Do we have original sound turned on? So let's put stop sharing for a moment. Turn off. I do have original sound turned on. Turn on original. So maybe. Oh no, maybe
so
they.
So now I have turn off original sound on my side.
That's what my side says also.
All right, so you turn on your original sound.
No, mine says turn off original sound so I can toggle it and we can see.
Okay. That's a second left word.
You can hear that, okay?
And the drum, do all three, drum singing.
Okay, so next, I guess when we, so,
So when you're gonna.
True sound was turned on to begin with, so I guess we need to turn it on and turn it off and turn it back on each time?
I don't know. Whatever you just did.
Yes.
I could hear all three components.
Yes.
The one previous with that, it took you into that warble mode.
Yes.
I was like, huh, but I could hear it because I could hear the beat.
I'm with you. So now this one can be done more complicated, but I'm kind of in the mood on this one for not to complicate it further, because what I'm focused on right now is getting all the pieces put together and getting used to singing and playing at the same time.
That's correct.
Like this one, you actually could start off playing five chords instead. I'm not saying the right word.
You're doing it right.
Like
intro.
That. You know, where it's. Semisonic actually plays that instead of a. They play a G5 instead of a G just to open. But. And I'm. Pardon?
Is this one not on ultimate guitar?
No, well, not the way I want to play it. And so, again, what I'm focused on right now is get the playing and singing down, and then as we improve, then I can make it more complicated another day.
No. I mean, yay.
Right?
That's right. Keep it simple.
Yeah, yep, yep. And so...
this is a good one.
Yeah,
so
good.
So far, the songs that you have introduced me to are songs that I haven't even ever thought about playing. And I like it, so good job. And I went back and found my database of like 100 cover songs that I used to play all the time.
Yay.
And I hadn't even thought about them because I've been playing so much of original music.
Yes.
Which is
and it's lovely that you play original music, but I agree. Play your songs and get people used to them, but then mix in different cover songs each Tuesday, each performance.
And I'm so, okay with it being songs I've never played before. I'm like, dude, I don't know how to play this, but I'm going to try. Here we go.
Yes. Well, or another way to, and you know all live performance anyway, but the other thing that it's possible to do is try and take requests.
I can do that. I have to put that input into my tip board, and I don't know how to do it yet. Like,
oh, usually. Yeah, make it a tip, right? If you tip $100, you get her your request.
something like that.
See, that's thinking.
That whole board, well, I've seen other artists, David, that's what they do. That whole board, I'm supposed to be able to do all kind of things with it, but I don't know how because I don't have anyone going, this is what you do, this is what you do.
Yes.
It took me 2 days to figure out how to get my picture on there.
Yes. And your chip jar said something different. It replied in a different way than the chip jar. Oh, it used my handle instead of my username when it said, thank you for the tip.
I don't even, I could probably automate it, but I was in such a quick hurry to find something yes. that was good.
Didn't work at all.
Yeah, I'm like, just go and we'll figure it out as we go.
That's exactly how I feel about picking up new songs every week, is first just learn to play it. You know, because if I said to people, okay, I just sang this song and I got the tempo right and I got the lyrics right and I got the notes right, but I played an open G instead of a G5, they'd be like, can't care. Don't understand what
public,
you're saying.
Public no but, care. Yeah, musicians so, be like, yeah, bro, that note breathe, that note doesn't
yeah,
breathe.
I can't so, believe yeah. you didn't play the bar chord G for that. Don't you remember when Semisonic played in Toronto, they played a bar chord G?
Like, no,
and I'm like, no, don't care. Sorry. I do care, and that's why I bring it up, but what I mean is...
Not right now. You just.
I need the guitar part of this to be on automatic so that I can sing. And then once I get used to doing this, and the more of this I do, it's just like everything else, right? It's exercise every day, because the more you do, the more you can.
And you should have a good set by probably February is my suggestion. And then you should definitely try some open mics on in Second Life.
Yeah, because we'll be up to 5 songs this week.
And you only
open mic, you only get to do 3 songs, so
some of them you can do longer, but in Second Life that's good because you could do an open mic here, an open mic there, an open mic there.
I've heard the lady at Starbucks, if you keep tipping her, you get to sing all 9.
Can't wait. Stuff is happening with that. I just
oh yay,
one breath at a time.
Next so this song. Song is, we're doing a reprise of last week's song, which is Otis Redding's Dock at the Bay by the late, great Otis Redding. This song, I think, is fundamentally about when you make a great big change in your life and you're expecting that that's going to really make a difference, and then it doesn't. So you make a big change, and then you're still the same person.
I can see that.
And now... there's a part of this song that cries out for a depressed person. However, the song is in the key of G and it's very upbeat. And so that makes me think this is kind of a bemused, a person who is feeling melancholy and is amused by the fact that he's feeling melancholy, if you will. Which we've all been there before, right? I can't believe you're in this situation again.
Can't believe I'm here in Austin, Texas.
Yes. This one, we're going to have the computer play the rhythm for us, and then we'll see how it goes. What I'm thinking on these middle weeks, we will really focus on the new song and the last song, the song from last week, and really try and polish those. And then as we get to the... So we have 3 new songs, song 1, song 2, song 3 on weeks 1, 2, 3. And then when we get to the 4th week, we'll try and play through them all.
That's good.
Does that make sense?
That makes sense. As new song, keep improving is what I hear.
Yes. Yeah, we played through the new song and we'll keep thinking about how to do closing time better. We'll spend more time on Dock of the Bay because that was the song from last week. And so we're really trying to polish this one. And then next week we'll get another new song and we'll play through
yes.
the last couple that way. I'll be sitting when the evening comes, watching the ships roll in, then I'll watch them roll away again, yeah, sitting on the dock of the bay, watching the tide roll away, sitting on the dock of the bay, wasting 'Cause I had nothing to live for. Looked like nothing gonna come my way. Sitting on the dock of the bay, watching the tide roll away. Sitting on the dock of the bay, wasting time. Looked like nothing's gonna change. Everything still remains the same. I can't do what 10 people tell me to do, so I'm out the same. That line bothers me, because if I were writing this song, so I can't do what 10 people tell me to do, so I guess I, and then he uses the verb there, remain the same. I would have made that stay the same so that it's a play on I've moved instead of not moving, but that always catches me because I disagree with the lyrical choice. 10 people tell me to, so I guess I'll remain the same. Sitting here resting my bones.
Oh, wait, in my version of the song, it's I guess I'll stay the same instead of remain the same. So maybe whoever copied it, and nope. I don't know if it's the original verse or not.
Otis says remain the same.
Yeah.
The version they have on Apple iTunes, Best of Otis Redding, he says remain the same. But you're right, he may have said stay the same on some performances and remain the same on other performances, and that's why it stuck in my head.
Yeah.
Yeah. We're going
to
be
stuck. It's a hard one to do. You need a breath in 90% of this. You need a breath. You need to breathe. And I recognize that you're trying to get the chords and the strumming in, so that will come. And it may be that you need to slow it down some more, just a tad, so you can get the breath in, because it's a feel good song.
I know.
That is not a feel good song.
it's that I haven't figured out the right way to describe that, but I am trying to work on my banter for each of these songs. Is why I'm doing those short introductions.
That's perfect, though.
You know, I think in this case he was hoping this would make a bigger change than it did. And I really think he was stuck because he wanted to do more pop songs, and everybody was telling him, you know, you're a rhythm and blues guy. You got to be what you are. You can't move into pop. Because that's not what your audience wants. I know, but that's what the people... Yeah. So when he's talking about, I can't do what 10 people tell me to do.
Which is the favorite part of that line. I'm like, that's so true, bro.
We're going to be stuck on this, so I'm going to, because it won't come back to the verse that we're on.
That's all right.
But we'll go from here. What's in my bone, and this loneliness won't leave me alone. 2,000 miles I've roamed just to make this dock my home. Yeah, sitting on the dock of the bay, watching the tides roll away. Sitting on the dock of the bay, wasting time.
Try to do the same thing, continue what you're doing, but try less strumming like we've done with most of the songs when you're singing, just to get the feel of the song. So,
yeah, I'm doing the single strum on the chorus, and then I'm doing
the single strum for a while. Let's see what happens.
I'm doing that I'm doing the single strum on the verses, and doing the down, 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 up, down on the chorus.
Deja vu.
Because the beat has that stuck in it.
Yes. One or the other has to simplify while you're singing, while you're getting used to singing.
Sitting in the morning sun.
Yes.
I'll be sitting. So that's what I've been doing on the verse. But when we come to the chorus, so what you're saying is just keep the chorus simple as well. Sitting on the dock of the bay, watching the tide roll away. Sitting on the dock of the bay, wasting time.
Yes. Okay. It gives you a chance to breathe, and because the drum beat has the dunkadaka dunkadaka, which you don't have to do. Which is hard to explain to people who don't sing all the time. So you're doing so well, Bruce. Oh, and you got the whistle. Okay. That's a hard part. You gotta have chapstick in there all the time.
So I'm working on the whistle. I got to get it stuck in my head is the problem, but I don't think this is actually the whistle on the outro, but let's see if it is. Let's tell it to solo that. Oh, it is. So I have to work on that.
It's one of the first whistles I learned how to do. I think it's actually the first whistle I learned how to do.
Nice. So that now I have not taken the semisonic and done and put it into Guitar Pro just this way, because what I wanted to do is just focus on, and in the back on the playing and singing, in the back of my mind, this one is what I was doing then was switching over to the other guitar.
Good chords, because it's easy. It's not hard.
That.
Good to sing and bar friendly.
And people like it. And people can sing along. They know this song. And so
That's what I need to do. I need to make some sing-along songs.
I put it in a PDF so that I could put it up on the screen, because that keeps my eyes closer to the camera.
Yes.
As opposed to looking down at a songbook.
That's right.
But it's still not, you know, the camera's up here and the thing's down here. So.
But you're in that vicinity. That's the way they teach us when you're doing public speaking. Look over them or through them.
Yes.
Chest area. That's a great tone on the guitar. I normally don't like this version. That sounds great.
Yeah, this one is... And this surprised me a little bit, because it's a combo crunch amp, which you might expect, but this is what I was talking about, that it's got a PQ pedal, and then the low gain and the mid gain are pushed up.
Is it the British Twin Fender? No, okay. Mid Boost CCO.
I'm sorry.
What you got. It says U22 mid boost combo.
Right.
So I'm wondering.
So the actual amp is a combo crunch amp, is what they're trying to say. So it's more of a you know, a heavy rock amp to begin with, and then the gain's pushed up to 90%.
It's a pretty distortion. I don't like distortion, but that's pretty.
And then, as I say, what I've done is pushed up. So if I turn off the PQ. But with the PEQ turned on, then it puts in more low and mid. Which, and I'm doing that just because that's what semisonic does, right? It's this beautiful, thoughtful song, and then they play it like a hard rock anthem.
Yeah. It's pretty. Oh, yeah.
So, and those are set together so that I can just hit the foot switch. The other thing I've got to do is rearrange so that I've got my guitar processor in front of me.
Mm-hmm.
Because I don't have to turn back what I'm tuning and so on, and you can hear. I did test the SM57 up as a vocal mic instead of the M7.
Yeah.
But I like the M7 better. It's a diaphragm mic, and so it gets a ton more volume. What do you think on the color? This is with no color added.
To the
vocals.
It's flat.
And then this is with a little bit of echo in it.
Reverb or echo?
They're
I
calling
like
it.
it's not, you're not flat. The other way is flat.
Yes. Now it goes, that's where they say is kind of in the middle, as if you were, you know, on a stage.
That sounds good, because it sounds like you have room to.
Then the modulation panel will let you say, well, if you want to go be over on the, you know, add different effects to your
alien.
Yeah.
You're going to have so much fun.
Position, if you're the singer on the right, then that will let you just, now it's only coming through the right instead of
center. Great toy, man.
And then this
great
one
toy.
Does voice color, so that you have more brightness and so on. But I think I'm right that if I can get, so I'm trying to get both of them at like 2 notches or 3 notches. And so now the guitar is testing 1, 2, 3, testing 1, 2, 3. So the mix is fine, right?
The mix is fine. When you're only speaking, the guitar drowns you out. So it makes a difference when you're singing as to speaking when you're testing.
Yeah, I did discover that during, what I wanted to do is during the banter do like the beginning intro chords. But you can't do that with the distorted guitar. It's too loud.
If you finger pick it and turn it down to like 1, you could.
Yeah, I also did volume up on the guitar, trying to get more tone out of the guitar and into the software. Mm-hmm. And so I did volume up and tone up on the guitar, and then just changing the tone in the software. The other, there's an overall out. And I reset those to just even. This is basically the main master settings. So low gain, where you want the mid to mid peak to be, and then mid gain and high gain. But in this case, because I'm using the PEQ for that purpose, then I just have this, you know, centered. And then the other thing we're doing on this one, this one's got 2 PEQs. That's a problem. I want to hear both. We probably don't need both, right?
One's fatter in sound.
Yeah.
But only the F2 is activated. F1 is not activated or highlighted.
Yeah, they're both activated. The F2 is highlighted.
Oh, the red light.
This red light means they're on. But the problem in my logic is F2 is cutting out my low and mids and pumping my high frequency. I was doing the opposite in F1. So let's put F1 here and turn off F2.
It's louder.
Well, do sound down a little bit.
I'm changing, I'm just saying it's a louder mid sound.
Now this one's pushing low frequency and mid-high frequencies. Low mid frequencies, mid-high frequencies. See, that one was pushing
high mids and highs.
High and not, yeah, the mids and not the lows. Mm-hmm. Now I've turned it down. So probably I just get rid of this PEQ because we don't need it as a PEQ. Just leave it turned off.
Number 2.
Yeah, we just use FX2. That will let me put this one on compressor. Compressor is one of my favorite pedals now. Anyway, I'll play with that when we're not live.
Well, this is good stuff to have live, because you can always go back and see what you were talking about. So it's good.
True fact. And then I've got it on an ambiance reverb. And we have, you know, all the regular choices here for room and hall and plate and spring and modulate and delay. And I had been using a lot of delay, but on this one, I don't think we need it because it's fat enough anyway, but we'll try the.
Now take the, oh, I hear it now. Take it off, let's see.
Yeah, when the mic turned up, I can hear my picking through the mic.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's another
thing. I'm gonna have to back that off a little bit.
That's just another thing about recording and having your mic.
Yes.
Your pick is so loud, but it's a good pick.
Yes.
I don't know how they. That must be a stressful edit mix for a person of sound. They have to go in there and mute that picking.
Well,
it's part of it.
I think. Too often what they do is go back and re-record the vocal track independently listening to the so that they just get vocals and not both.
It's a requirement and it's very hard to do.
Yeah.
You want me to sing and don't play. Okay, I have to remember how to do that. Wait.
Yeah, that would be a good thing. So we're going to save this one off as I'm going to save this one off as a separate thing so that I can go back to the original one versus this one. Now it's writing to the pedal, and that way if I wasn't using the software, I can just use the pedal to flip in between one and the other.
What? That's so nice.
That's the one we started with. This is the one without the double PEQ. Very subtle difference.
But enough for a.
No, I won't keep them both. It's just I want to go back and study which one I prefer. Mm-hmm. Obviously, I don't want to have this pedal with two PEQs going, one just on the guitar and then one on the amp and the guitar. That doesn't make good sense to me. But we'll see. And then this is the setup we're using for most of the simple pick songs, is I'm using an MS-1959 amp with a lower gain. With a little delay and a room reverb. And so basically low gain, and we're actually using a 4x12 speaker. We could probably turn that down to a... Let's get back on to like Dock of the Bay. So it's got a little chiminess in it done that way, but it that's about as close as to how the guitar actually sounds. This one is just the guitar pushed through. Let's actually turn that off. So that's just the guitar with pedals, no amp simulation. No coloring from an amp. That's just got a compressor on it and reverb, room reverb, and standard delay. And it's a little bit too loud right now is what it sounds like. Let's
scooch.
A little bit, a lot too loud right now. So we'll turn. I can still hear the pick, but
that sound won't go away, Bruce. It's just
do you want it to?
No.
Okay.
I don't.
I'll stop worrying about it. It sounds like it's live playing, right?
That's correct. And when you get live, you get live. You're not recorded, you're live.
Okay. So you're okay with that song pick, and what we'll do. Well, we got time for one more song. The Killing Me Softly, we're on Capo 4. Do you have anything else we wanted to cover this week?
No, I am very pleased with your progress.
I am glad. I feel like it's coming swimmingly. It's coming a little bit better now as I get more used to playing and singing. And I like this idea of let's do a new song every week and then polish the other songs and try and build up, you know, a card where people, in other words, take requests, but take requests from a card. Like your 60 songs that you knew back in the day seems perfect, because then you could put it on a card in Second Life and say, any of these songs you can pick. So it's not you're just taking requests willy-nilly, right?
Right. Because
play Wonderwall.
They'll be like, play Stairway to Heaven. They'll be like, shut your face.
Play the third song on Stevie Ray Vaughan's fourth album. No.
No.
It's not, you know, pick from the 60 songs as you suggested, make it a pure, for a $100 donation, you get a song off the list of 60. If you want me to write a song in real time, it's 4,000 lindens.
Or I can even, I can custom make you a song as well.
Exactly. And then list the price for that to be played next Tuesday. Let's see if I remember this one. Strumming my pain with her fingers. We left the guitar on the wrong thing. With the words. Killing me softly with her song.
Does something really weird. I don't know what that is, but okay. Otherwise.
Oh, it does a little dee-doo at the, there's a little dee-doo at the end of one of the.
Yes.
Do we want to lose that?
Uh-huh. I was like, why is it going there? My ears went.
Yeah, I know it does that. I will have to, I think it must be in the chorus.
Or just turn it down. It's actually overpowering me. overpowering your vocals.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So let's put... Oh, we could just turn off the male vocals. I use that for practicing so that I can stay in tune with the melody.
That's perfect. That's good.
But we can just turn it off for... And I got to get my strumming patterns back. So we were starting this one with the... the single note strumming, and then we're going to the during the rest of the verses we were doing the and then when it goes to the chorus it comes to the four up down up down down up down. And so I'm happy with that. I probably need to, and it actually shows that in the rhythm track here, and so I just need to keep it in mind. The big thing I remember about this one is remember it comes back to A minor when it's coming to the next verse. So that when you get to the end, look out, you need to be playing aim when you get to here. Look out, it's coming back to A minor. Look out, it's coming back to A minor. Anyway, I'll keep playing through this. What I have been doing is playing through each of them, but for whatever reason that one stuck. It's and I have to ask my wife not to print during guitar lessons.
Okay, I was like, I don't know what's happening, but it sounds good. Goes with it. I like what you're doing, sir.
Good. Thanks for being on. Sorry we ran a little late. And no, let me good. Stop sharing. Stop sharing.
Because we do the thing that I like the best, which is the talking. So.
All right, good job on your set last night, as I said last night. But you know, keep going.
I had fun. I was like, I'm just going to thing, and I'm not thinking.
And that's... cathartic, right?
Oh, yeah. When I can just sing and not think, it's great.
Yeah. All right. Have a good night.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.